All praise be to Allah and peace be upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Did you know that spider silk is incredibly tough and is strong by weight than steel? Quantitatively, spider silk is 5 times stronger than steel of the same diameter.
Is this serious? So how does the Quran refer to this? As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran, وَإِنَّ أَوْهَنَ الْبُيُوتِ لَبَيْتُ الْعَنْكَبُوتِ لَوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ. I'm a little confused now. In this way, the Quran contradicts science.
You shouldn't be confused and know that true science never contradicts the Quran. The Quran and science come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, they will never contradict each other. So the problem here is in your understanding.
In my understanding? How can this be? Please explain what you mean.
Please read this verse.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. مثل الذين اتخذوا من دون الله أولياء كمثل العنكبوت اتخذت بيتا وإن أوهن البيوت لبيت العنكبوت لو كانوا يعلمون.
Repeat the second part.
وَإِنَّ أَوْهَنَ الْبُيُوتِ لَبَيْتُ الْعَنْكَبُوتِ لَوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ. Now I understand. In the verse, Allah refers to the spider's house, not its silk material.
Excellent work. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says the weakest of the houses is the house of a spider. There is a miracle in this verse that the Quran tells us that the female spider takes over the house, controls it, and after incubation kills the male spider. Scientists confirm what the Quran al-Kareem told 1400 years ago, that the female spider builds and takes the house. As stated above, that the word ittakhazat with the feminine ta is mentioned in the verse and refers to the female spider. Additionally, the female spider kills her male. She has a house where the guests are hunted. And the worst thing is that her baby spiders will kill their mother when they grow up. As a result, we understand why the Quran described the house of a spider as the weakest of all houses. House of betrayal, cheating, and murder. It is the most unwelcoming place in the world. Lastly, this house has a weak design and protection, as it cannot block the sun, heat, rain, wind, and etc.
SubhanAllah, 1400 years ago, nobody could have imagined the scientific miracles described in the verse. Al-Quran describes precisely that spiders are the weakest of the houses because they betray each other and kill one another.
It should now be clear to you what the verse means. Accordingly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the verse that those who take allies with others, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will suffer. People who worship statues, animal or humans, to protect them, those who rely on their intelligence, friends, soldiers or wealth instead of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are exactly like a female spider who takes shelter in a weak house. It is a house full of dangerous and it cheats without basic protection and the only temporary settlement. It is a great example from the Holy Quran that shows the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his creation, as well as teaches us to rely and depend only on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Since Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is excellent, excellent is the protector and excellent is the helper. Now that you know what a weak home is, wouldn't it be nice to know which house is the best, which is full of mercy, peace and tranquility, which is abundant with blessings and rewards? It is the masjid, a home with which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises those who build it in this world, Allah will reward them with a home in paradise. It is amazing how generous Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. And imagine if you attend such a home where the rewards of it are endless even after death. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said, when a man dies, his deeds comes to an end except for three things. Sadaqa jariya, continuing the charity, knowledge which is beneficial, or a virtuous descendant who prays for him. It is so blessed that beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam built it with his own hands, lived next to it, and is buried within the area of it in Al-Masjid al-Nabawi in Al-Madinah al-Munawwara. So the lovers of our beloved Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, would you not love to imitate his sunnah and love the masjid like he did? So take a look at your masjid and how you can make it a better place. Look at the state of your masjid. Would you not wish for this to be the best home? Thank you, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you and make our masjids into our homes. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.